All right, so what is good, everybody on YouTube? This is, of course, your boy B, Boy RC, coming to you guys again with yet another video. And today, I mean, the stacks, the blessings, you guys can kind of see in the back right now, the blessings are pretty strong. So we got another big men's streetwear haul, a lot of different things, and I even got some blessings from a subscriber. I got a lot of stuff that I've been unboxing. I'm just not gonna have enough time to get into everything before I leave for SneakerCon Bay Area. So today I'm gonna go ahead and go through everything you guys see right here, and the major delayed W is also in the stack. Shouts out to the homie on Twitter, but we will get into that probably closer to the end. So with all that being said, y'all already know what time it is. Clothing haul, blessings on blessings on blessings on blessings. Let's get it.
I got so much beef, I can barely sleep. Paranoia got me losing on my Z's all day. Good Lord, mama praying on the knees all day. If you still frontin' when I up it, I'ma squeeze. Bad companies, bad for your company. Bad companies, bad for your company.
So first things first, in that unboxing, you guys might have seen a couple things that I'm not gonna talk about yet. Those are a couple future summer sample releases, but we also had this jacket right here, which is dropping Saturday, March 30th at 8 p.m. Eastern time. $80 on the jacket. Should have been more for sure, but we were being a little bit nice on the price, if you ask me. That's my honest opinion. Now, this right here is the Sample Industries Anniversary Motorsports Jacket. And obviously, it's designed after old school NASCAR type jacket. So the whole build on this one is a really nice, heavy cotton twill. And then on the front, you got a lot of different logos that we've done. Atlanta, you have LA logo, Chicago, Miami, Phoenix, one a few micro on the front. You got the checker flag underneath that, and everything on this is going to be 100% embroidered, and also the fit is true to size. The size I have on in the b-roll is a size XL, fits me perfectly fine. So even with my true size on this joint, I can throw in a hoodie underneath of it and I'm not feeling all choked up. So the idea behind this, since it is an anniversary jacket, is that it has an or pays homage to all the logos and different things that we did last year in 2017, which I'll get into. So on the right sleeve, you have the 17, you have the Dallas logo, Australia logo, Bay Area, and then Industries. If we hop over into the left sleeve, you got the flag up top, the 6 for Toronto. All In is actually designed from something that hasn't dropped yet, but you guys will be seeing that soon. The El Toro Racing on the sleeve is also from a design that never actually dropped. It was a design that I had made, and it just didn't come through the way I wanted to. The shirt that I had made, I really wanted it to be perfect, and the colors just weren't there, so we ended up not dropping. I just scrapped it, because if it wasn't going to be done 100% right, I wasn't going to do it at all. And then also you got the Cavaliers S and then Sample on that side. And it being a NASCAR jacket, is going to have a lot of branding, a heavy branding on it. And then also a little hidden detail, because when you're wearing it, you can kind of see it, but you also kind of folds down so you can't see it. It does have 22 Wild embroidered in, and then my name, of course, Bullet RC on the right side. And on the inside, once again, Sample Motors, and my tag is an XL. Every tag is going to be a little bit different depending on your size, but unique tags on these. And these will be dropping once again March 30th for $80, 8 p.m. Eastern time. So if you want to cop it, go ahead, 8 p.m. be there. And this joint, I really like the colors on this one, really like how this one came out. But yeah, cotton twill NASCAR joint. And let me go ahead and throw this back in the bag.
Mag in the ski mask in case you come for me. Got the mag in the ski mask in case you come for me. When I say I got beef, they don't want no beef. When they say they got beef, they don't want to eat. If you said they want smoke, they don't want no steam. She put a beat on a T.
First things first, let's get into these two Pata pickups. Now, I saw them post these t-shirts on their IG. I think it was this color one right here, which I think is called like Camilla or something. But I saw them post it up on the IG and I was like, yo, I need to grab one of these t-shirts before they sell out. So I did go ahead and grab these in a double XL, because when I grabbed an XL before, to me, it just seemed like they fit a little bit too slim on the size for me. Now, I will have to go ahead and crop these just a little bit. I'm gonna have to hem these up on the bottom just because they're a little bit too long. I didn't really mind them being too wide, because once again, I can just go ahead and shrink it. But this one right here just says It's a Wild World on the back, got Pata across it, and this really weird orangish color. It's really hard to communicate the colors over the camera. And then you just got the small Pata branding right here on the left chest. Now it's the same for this yellow t-shirt. Once again, I just really, really like the colors on these. Same size, but it was just a little bit too long, so I probably had to just cut it and then hem it up on the bottom and just keep it moving. I will have to shrink it just a little bit because it is a little bit wide, but I was kind of prepared for that. I'd rather get the size double X and then go ahead and kind of fix and alter a little bit to my size, then get the XL and just fit a little bit too slim to where I didn't really want to wear it. So that's actually why there was no on body B-roll. You guys might see me wearing this exact tee in one of my past videos. I think I was wearing this one on an Instagram photo, and once again, it's just super long on me. So Pata, Wild World, yellow, and this crazy orange colorway. If you guys have never heard of Pata, definitely give them a follow on IG. Dope brand in my opinion. So let's get into the next one. Bachelor's degree, PhD while selling speed. Fix the face and fix the weed. Now working on the self-esteem. Hit a block, yo, this flop. Nigga, where you at? Pin the drop. My new map location be the flop on the app. Now these next two pickups that I got right here are actually some blessings from a subscriber. So shouts out to Sean. He said he's the owner of Finch Archives, which is his brand. He had another brand and, you know, some business things happened and he did his own thing. So this is from Sean. And once again, I will be linking everything down below. So if you like this hoodie or if you like this hat, hey, go ahead and cop it. He just sent it to me for free to the P.O. box. And he was just like, yo, if you fuck with it, fuck with it. If you don't, then you don't. So I have two pieces right here. First up, I'm gonna start with this hat. And it just says, I did some things so she could love me. And then towards the back, you do have a bird. It's a regular all black dad cap with the strap on the back. And just some sad boys vibes, kind of some sad boys vibes on the hat and some sad boys vibes as well on the hoodie. But I actually really like this. I wasn't really sure how I was feeling about the whole kind of rhinestoned out stuff that's been dropping or people have been dropping. I kind of played around with some designs to do that for sample, but I feel like this rhinestone design, I don't know how much staying power it has. I think it's gonna be a trend that kind of passes quickly. I could be wrong, but it does look cool and it does look nice when it's done up right. One thing I would say, even though I do like this hoodie, Sean, is that maybe you should space out the letters a little bit more or just play around with offsetting some of the letters. I definitely still like how they're placed, but I think adding something a little bit different to the font or just playing around or misplacing some of the letters might give it a better look on the hoodie. It might just give it a little bit of a different look, and that would be my constructive criticism of what I would do personally, at least spacing out the letters just a little bit. But overall, it's an all black hoodie and it's all based on top of a Champion Eco Authentic hoodie. So it's a more thinner hoodie. It's not the reverse weave from Champion, but you do have the Champion logo on the sleeve. But once again, I actually do really like this hoodie. You know, definitely some sad boy steez going on, loner and doing things that show she could love me, but I don't know, I kind of fuck with it. So Sean, I appreciate the blessings, and I might actually be taking this on my trip to the Bay Area. So if you guys see me wearing this, now you know exactly where it came from. I'll probably leave that hat here, but I don't know, I fuck with the rhinestone stuff, but when it's done right, it's done right. And I do like how it's done here, but I just gave kind of my constructive criticism. You can take that however you want to, Sean. Overall, I fuck with the pieces and I appreciate it. Up next, you guys saw me running around DC, and I told y'all when I had a chance, I do some better shots on some of the stuff I grabbed from Diet Starts Monday. So I got two hoodies right here, and I'm gonna start off with this joint right here because I can't fit it yet. It is a size large, almost there, but fits me a little bit tight in the arms and the shoulders. I'm pretty sure I can figure it out in the future, but for right now, it's an all over charcoal gray, very, very heavy Terry Fleece on this. Definitely a quality, definitely a nice quality, heavy feeling hoodie. It almost has that washed out charcoal over dyed look to it, but I don't think that this is an over dyed hoodie. It could be, but it definitely looks like this might have just been some nice gray color that they chose. On the front says diet, feel better, live longer, and it says Monday, I promise. And you have the skeletons, and I just really fuck with the actual hoodie on the back. You do have a middle seam going down the back just to give it a little bit of texture, just another little hit. And I don't know, I just really fuck with this hoodie. I really wish I could have got it in a size XL, but the biggest size they had was a large. So in a few, once again, I'll be able to wear these. And I really like what they've done with the drawstring. This is just weird white and gray elastic draw cord. So Diet Starts Monday joint, all over gray. Definitely like the graphic on these and the feel, the quality. This hoodie right here was the main reason I actually went out there. And it's really hard to explain. It looks like, hopefully the B-roll can help me out a little bit. But on the front, it does say Diet once again. It has like this cracked athletic font on the front, kind of reminiscent of an old varsity or kind of college jersey or a college hoodie that's been kind of washed out and worn, but a good worn in look nonetheless. And the overall hoodie is like this purple acid washed out, bleached out feel. And like I said in the video, kind of reminds me of some of the Cactus Plant flea market stuff. Yellow drawstrings, once again, yellow stretchy drawstrings on here. And as far as fitting goes, I would say these fit true to size. They do not have like a slim fit. It is more of a baggy fit on these. But man, this hoodie is fire. Definitely something I'm gonna have in my wardrobe for a long time. And this isn't as heavy of a terry cotton at all. This is more of a fleece cotton on the inside versus the super heavy other hoodie that we just talked about. This is a more lightweight fleece hoodie, more geared towards, I would say, spring and summer for those who can wear hoodies in the spring and summer. But yo, this hoodie is straight fire. Glad I was able to grab this. Unfortunately, I think both of these hoodies are sold out online. But if you are in the DC area, stop by Dye Stars Monday and they might have your size. Once again, go true to size. And yeah, man, just a really, really dope hoodie. Love the fit, love the wash, love the look, love the worn in textures to it. And yeah, so those are the two Dye Stars Monday hoodies. We got more boxes, so let's get into them.
You can't hang, baby. We don't want you around here. Ice on my neck and it's froze. Santa's reindeer. You got bad bitches, hella hoes. It's the same here. Bad company, lil' bro. You can't hang here. Getting money, so the bottles keep on coming. Pop my phone ringing, so you know the trap jumping.
So as you guys just saw, once again, End Clothing coming through with the blessings. Frugal Boy Stand Up. I got all this stuff discounted with a really decent discount in my opinion. And all of this stuff is Yeezy Calabash. I think it's season 5 or season 6 stuff. So once again, let me put this box down and we'll get into each thing one by one. So first off, we're going to keep it clean and keep it very nice and cozy. Now all three of these sweatpants retailed at I think $300 or $310, and I got them for $180 a pop each. So almost half off for every pair. Now, the reason I say we're talking cozy first is because these joints, they fit pretty nice. I would like it to be maybe a more slim fit towards the leg, but it's not a bad look at all. Now, the reason I mentioned cozy is because all these pants, I'm gonna start off with these right here. This is the Oxblood colorway. They have a really heavy, once again, terry fleece, but at the same time, a very stretchy terry fleece. And all of this stuff is over dyed. So again, it's gonna have that washed out, somewhat vintage look to it. Hey, take a drink every time I say washed out or vintage or over dyed in this video. Let me know how that goes in the comments. Anyways, the first ones we got right here are the Oxblood colorway, and I always get mine in size large. I'm a 36 waist. I usually do an XL in sweatpants, but these to me definitely fit big, and you can go down a full size. Adidas and Calabasas logos on the front right thigh area, basically right below the pocket. They are zipper pockets on these. And then I do like how they've done the paneling on this. It almost has a distressed look once again. Calabasas on the side, and this is the Oxblood colorway. This might be my favorite colorway out of all of them. I thought I was really gonna like the Luna ones better, but in hand, this Oxblood one is definitely a good look. And if they are still on End Clothing for sale, I will link them all below. Next up though, I got another pair, and this one is the Luna pair. And I actually thought this was gonna be a lot lighter of a blue, but it's like a dark teal colorway. And a lot of the same exact details, the same terry fleece, the same stretch to it. Adidas Calabasas on the right next to the pocket. Calabasas down the right side of the leg. And once again, it's just a good fit. It's a good feel, and I went with a size large and these as well. These were also over dyed, and I think that process of over dyeing is why these were more expensive than some of the other Calabasas sweatpants. But all in all, good fit, good feel once again. And the last pair, I don't have any b-roll because I figured after both of those you guys would kind of get the point with these. I did pick up this colorway, is called Ink, and yeah, I'm not gonna repeat the lingo again, but y'all know what these are. All black, charcoal feel to them. Calabasas sweatpants, can't go wrong with them. So three new pairs, three new cozy fits for me. And these will go very well with another pickup that I got coming later in the video. Next up and last up out of that box, I also had another Cali Sport tee. Now you guys know the last one that I grabbed, these do fit way way, way oversized. So go two sizes down. I tried a large this time because they didn't have any mediums in stock on the sale. This is usually a $130 t-shirt, or I don't want to just call it a t-shirt. It's more of a heavyweight French terry cotton shirt. I don't want to downplay the quality on this because, once again, I bought another one of these t-shirts because I have another one, and the quality is just very, very nice. I mean, to me, it's an $80 t-shirt that is worth it. I know that some people wouldn't spend that on a t-shirt at all, and it's all good. Everyone has their preferences. But this one right here, I grabbed in a size large, and it is still really, really, really big. So, man, in Calabasas or Yeezy Season 5, some of these Cali Sport tees, bruh, I might be a medium or even a small. So next time I buy another one, it will definitely be in a size medium. And once again, I didn't grab the medium because they were sold out. But all over, and this colorway is called Jupiter. Really nice printing on the Cali Sport on the left chest. And in the B-roll, I know I'm kind of wearing with a long sleeve. In real life, I probably wouldn't wear it with a long sleeve. I'd probably just wear it over a hoodie, or if I really want to wear it by itself, I could do that. Just know it is gonna be floating on you. You can take off even in the size large. So if you're going for anything like this, I think the sweaters fit true to size, but this stuff right here, the t-shirts, if it says oversized fit or boxy, go two sizes down. I'm using XL, definitely would have liked a medium in this, but nonetheless, still a dope colorway, Cali Sport, and goes great with the 500 Desert Rats or blush joints. But let me toss this in the back because we got more shit.
That nigga looking at me, he owe me some money.
I need that.
Hit him with the Tommy, now that nigga crumpin'.
Why
these niggas playing games? They don't want no problems with me. My shooters got good aim. You know I brought them shotters with me. Might not hit a bad stop. They say that someone top was missing. Them niggas were opposition.
They move wrong.
So I shot them bitches.
Dark shades too much.
Shouts out to Puma for this package. I wasn't even expecting this extra one because you guys know I did a little work with Puma on IG for the Big Sean release, and they actually sent me a whole nother package. So all white box, Puma and Big Sean, take off the top. We're gonna get into the shoes first because the shoes are hard, but the suit really, really impressed me. So once again, I'm gonna toss this in the back, toss this down, and let's get into the shoebox first. So this right here should look very, very familiar to you guys if you watch some of my older unboxings. You take this top off the box, and this is actually a different color from the collab. And it's a really soft gray. And these joints, the off-white ones are hard, but I feel like I like these OG all gray suedes better than the off-white pair. And let me tell y'all, the quality of materials on this shoe right here is, I mean, in hand, the suede, they definitely went all out for this collab. And I think they did a really, really good job with this shoe. Now, they did actually come with two different sets of laces, kind of a gray and darker gray lace, and then an all flat gray. I stuck with the flat gray. They do have like the brass metal tips on the outside, or the copper metal tips on the outside. I just like the flat gray. I didn't really like the two contrasting grays because the whole shoe isn't two different color grays. It's one gray. So I went with the regular flat gray. Once again, take a shot every time I just said gray. Let me know how that goes. Still, once again, you see some of those details from the other collab, the blue, white, and green on the pull tab, green on the insole, Detroit Puma logos on the tongue, and that jewel emerald green sole, a really, really good look. Puma and Big Sean, I think they did a great job on the shoes, but the apparel that came with it as well was dope, and that's what we're gonna get into right now. So now we're in cozy mode once again, and let's get into these suits, bro. I think they killed the suits to go with this. So first off, I'm gonna start with the tee, and then we're gonna break down the full suit. So this t-shirt right here, you can't even call it a t-shirt. It's like a terry towel fleece all over. It feels like a nice soft towel. Just feels like sand in the beach on a nice sunny day. Puma and Big Sean Detroit logos embroidered in. And then you do have that tag, blue, white, and green on the back. I'm gonna just tell y'all, man, this t-shirt itself is just nice. It's soft, and it's like a really soft velour touch on the t-shirt. So that's the shirt, and let's jump in to the suit because the black suit was hard, but I think I like the gray suit over the black suit in my opinion. Starting off up top, you got this all over gray. It's a cotton, it says cotton, 97% cotton and 3% elastane mix, and this joint is just super cozy, super comfortable, and not too heavy to a point where you can't wear it on some of those warmer days. So you got this regular cotton and polyester mix on the middle. You got satin on the sleeves. Then you also have that velour strip, very cozy velour strip on the sleeves as well. And then you have these different hits of the Big Sean collab with the green, white, and blue. And on the left sleeve, you have the Puma Detroit logos. Once again, green, white, and blue ribbing. And yo, I mean, I don't want to pump up the suit. You know, I'm not going to gas it, but I'm going to just let y'all know. With this suit on, I found myself grabbing this. After I've had, I've probably worn the full suit 3 times. Definitely need to wash this joint, and I will after this video. But yeah, the suit is hard. So that was the top. And then as we go to the pants, it's the same exact thing. I got the top in an XL. I got the pants in an XL, and they both fit great. Same details on the pants. Cotton and elastane. Velour strips down the side. Cozy for sure. Cozy level on 100. And then on the back right leg, you have that Puma and Big Sean Detroit logo embroidered in with some more of that multicolored ribbing. Man, this suit right here is fire. Extra cozy. I love the velour hits on the ribbing, or at least the striping down the sides. The velour hits are clean, and this green, white, and blue mix, these colors that they picked look really well. And just the colors that they picked as well, this blue, white, and green, just go really well with the suits. And I'm gonna just tell y'all, bro, I know, I don't know why I'm surprised that Puma does a great tracksuit, but trust me, this is way far and beyond what I thought it was gonna actually be. So yeah, Puma, Big Sean collab, tracksuits, the shirts. If you haven't checked it out, I recommend you at least checking out some of the stuff.
Smoke, got the Billy, see the fumes. Acting brand new like I don't see it when I do. Who them folks, who want smoke? You too close, give me room. Phony folks, play it close, do the most, don't they? Bad company, that's bad for your company. Bad company, that's bad for your company. Bad cow disease, now you in a ton of beef. Black mag tucked underneath my new blue dungarees. Flintstone bust down, call Americana.
And to end the video off with a bang, with the delayed W I needed, the Reptar boots themselves, the Tyrannosaurus Rex boots themselves, the Yeezy Boost 700 in a US size 12. Shouts out to the homie Neon Black Ranger on Twitter. He hooked it up for that retail delayed dub, the Yeezy 700 Wave Runner, the one that people love to love and the people love to hate. I mean, these look even better in person. I think it's just because the bulky look, but also they just got that toe box right on these joints. So, I mean, I'm gonna play some B-roll. I know you guys have seen this shoe all over the place. Of course, recently they restocked. The resale prices kind of dipped a little bit, and the homie hit me up and he definitely helped me out. So I now own a pair of the 700s. So I have 350s, 350 V2s, 750s. I feel like I'm missing the 500s, and I feel like I'm missing something. Some other Yeezy around the studio somewhere. But once again, shouts out to Neon Black Ranger. This was a shoe I really was trying to get. And when these restocked, bruh, I think the best way to get them was definitely gonna be Yeezy Supply. And I struck out a couple times on Yeezy Supply. Adidas wasn't showing the kid no love, but the homies on Twitter had me locked down, and I really do appreciate it, man. The colors on the shoe look really good. The materials on the shoe are really done well, and I really like the sole. I know some people don't like that chunkier sneaker, but I definitely do like the sole. Got the Boost on the bottom. I mean, it's the 700 Wave Runner, the ones you guys all know, the ones we all speculated about, I guess, over a year ago when we first saw them, and I'm just glad to have them, and even more glad that one of you guys out there were nice enough to bless the kid with that delayed W. And you guys know I will be posting these up on IG very soon. So thank you to Neon Black Ranger. Shouts out to Puma, that starts Monday in clothing. I will link everything down below. If you wanna go cop something, or at least check out a site, check out a sale, the links are down there for you. Wave Runners, 700s, that's it. So I'm out of here. Much love to all the fam, followers, and of course, supporters. You guys can follow me on Instagram, Twitter, SoundCloud, Snapchat. The Snapchat is bull.cb, by the way. Here, there, blase, blood, of course, Bullet RC. And I will see you on the next video. 700s, got them secured. Retail delayed W. How can you beat it? Can't pass it up. So that's it. Y'all let me know what was your favorite pickups from this video. Anything that you guys liked or any brands that you think I should check out, hey, drop a comment down below. And if I fuck with it, maybe you'll see it pop up on the channel. The P.O. Box is always open. I got some more stuff from you guys, some more blessings that we'll be showing off soon. But let me go ahead and head to the Bay Area, do that SneakerCon thing. And when we get back, we will handle all that. So that's it. I'm out of here. Y'all be easy. Much love, once again, from the heart. I appreciate y'all. Peace. Fruity pebble, bezel, Wilma, Betty, bread and Barney, bad bitch from out of town. I think she model, have my commie. Risk game, lucky chummy, told my jeweler, leper, commie. I'ma come clean, I got hella beef. Paranoia got me rolling on my sleeves, okay. Niggas say.